VLC Media Player. We all have used this amazing piece of software to play different video files, audio files, and it was in fact the only software to support all kinds of codec and video and audio formats. It was pretty much the king of all media players a decade ago. But now, in 2021, it's not amazing anymore, is it? As you can see here, it looks dated. It looks dated and very boring for a modern media player. I have faced a lot of crashes and slowdowns with this player, and now when I have used other players like PotPlayer, I realized that there are a lot of missing features in VLC that should have been there. And also, many people tend to use this software just because they don't know about any other better media player, or they are too lazy to go and install a different software and invest the time to know about all the ins and outs of that software. And so through this video, I will try to change that and talk about a PotPlayer, which is a very good media player and much better than VLC. So without any further ado, just dive right in. And to install PotPlayer, you just need to go to Google and type PotPlayer and search for it, and it will lead you to the website. So this is the website, and just download the 64-bit version. Currently, PotPlayer only supports Windows XP, Vista 7, 8, 8.1, and it also supports Windows 10, which is not mentioned here, but it still does, and I don't know why they have not mentioned it. And also, this player is not supported in Mac, so for Mac people, you just look for another software. And after installing this media player, you just don't have to install any other codec or nonsense bullshit. You just need this media player, and it's completely fine. Just like VLC media player, it supports all the current codec and video and audio formats. So as soon as we launch PotPlayer, it looks something like this. So it has a darker theme, so which is very soothing to the eyes. Also, it looks very much modern and much better than VLC, which looks completely dated. It crashes a lot, and a lot of things why I switched to this media player. And honestly, this is exactly what you need, and just give it a try and you will understand what I'm talking about. So first of all, we'll talk about the basic controls that this software has. To control the volume, this is very basic. You just need to scroll up and down and the volume will be controlled, or you can just go here and control with the slider. Very easy, very basic. To go full screen, you just press enter and there you are. And also, they have put a full screen button right here next to the close button and the maximize minimize button. I like it this way. There is a dedicated full screen button. Just before talking further, just let me open a file, and it will be easier for me to demonstrate and talk about all other things. So here we are. This is a movie, Rise of the Guardians. It was released in 2012, and let me play this with PotPlayer. And so here we are. To full screen, as I said, you just full screen with enter or click here, and it has the same effect. To fast forward 5 seconds, you just click the right arrow. To go back 5 seconds, press the left arrow, and it's easy. It's also the same as VLC media player. To pause and play, you just press spacebar. It is again same as VLC. And now to change the window sizes, all we can do is press 1 to just go to 0.5 times the current window size, then press 2 for the default look, again 1, it will minimize and go to the 0.5 times. So you can switch that way. Also, you can press the tilde key and it will hide the video and only show the audio. So you can do that also. It is very nice if you just want to listen to the audio and do not want any video on your screen. Further, just let me maximize it. Okay, so further, we can increase the playback speed by just pressing C and X key on your keyboard. Just press C and there you have it. The playback speed increased. Press X and the playback speed will decrease. You can go as low as 0.2 times and as high as 12 times. Yes, that is the maximum limit. So just let me reset it again. Okay, there we have it. Now, a very nice feature to have in this media player is the ability to move one frame forward and to the previous frame. So this feature is yet not there in VLC. There is this option to like move to the next frame by pressing E, but you cannot move to the previous frame, which is a bummer. So in PotPlayer, you can do that. Just by pressing F and D, you can move one frame, a single frame forward, like just like that. Press D and move one frame backward. Just by pressing D, you can move one frame backwards, just like that. Okay, so it's very simple. To copy the current frame to your clipboard, you just need to press Ctrl and then C, and that will copy the frame, the current frame, to the clipboard. So that is a very handy feature to have. Further, if we move here and press F9, we get this playlist and browser options, and from here only you can access any files on your computer. You don't have to like go to the movies folder and just click and search for your file. You just open PotPlayer, and there in the browser section you have all your files that you want to play. Also, there is a navigator option apart from browser and playlist, and to access that you just press F12 and then it opens this quick window to access any file on your PC. So for that, if I just want to play like this in a single click, and then just click it, and there you have it. And there you have it. You can just very easily, like just press F12, and you can very easily switch between files. And it is very nice to have a feature like that. Okay, so moving further. So we can of course change the skin of this media player. And for now, I will just increase the contrast and darkness of the skin a bit. And so for that, I just go to PotPlayer, I go to skins, then I go to color themes, then customize, then just decrease this to 25. Just decrease that color. And as you can see, the color changes, and I just need to get this darker, and there you have it. The thing has just become darker and I like it this way. So if we press the F7, we can access the control panel, and this is so much easier to like just have the audio and video, brightness, contrast, equalizer, all built in here. So if you just want to change the equalizer or just change the brightness or contrast of any video, just quickly press F7 and go to video, and there you have it. You can just increase the brightness, contrast, saturation, anything, and if you play, it changes. So this looks very ugly, and so I'm going to just change it to default. So just you can do it that way. Also, you can turn the equalizer on and off. You can control the subtitles from here and the playback speed from here also. There is also a very cool feature here, and that is to just control Z, and there it is. It just shows the mirror image of the what the file actually is. So it is a very cool thing to have. Just let me reduce the volume a bit. So it is very nice to have. The file is like this, but if we press control Z, it just shows me the mirror image of that. And after that, we can also control the subtitles. So for controlling the subtitles, let me open a different file so that I can show you better. So here I have opened the Harry Potter and the Goblet of Fire file. awesome movie, go check it out. To show the subtitle, just press L and there you have it. So right now .srt is loaded, and if I want to switch off the subtitle, just press off and the subtitle vanishes away. Okay, let me reduce the volume a bit. So again, if we want to have it, press L, go to SRT and the subtitles appear. And to cycle between subtitles, we can press Alt L, and as you can see here, we can switch on or switch off the subtitle just by pressing Alt and L. Now, if you want to customize, there is also an option to customize the subtitle. So for that, you just right click, go to subtitles, and then you have the option subtitle style, and you have this font settings. Okay, so this font settings will allow you to change the how your subtitles look. There you have it. If I want to just have a different font like this one and just want to increase the subtitle size, you just do it from here. Okay, and the subtitle size change, as you can see here. Now let me show you one thing. I just observed that if we play any file through VLC media player, the subtitles position is very bad, and I don't know why, but it is on the video and it is very difficult and annoying sometimes to just have the subtitle on your movie itself. So that is very bad and outdated. And for PotPlayer, we have the subtitles just below the movie frame, and if we go to full screen, we just see that the subtitles appear below the frame, and it is very convenient and it is not annoying as that in VLC. So after that, to access the settings or preferences, as we call it, we just press F5, and there we have it, and we can access the settings, and will take you pretty much half an hour just to see all the settings that there is here. So we can control the interface language, control how the position is when we start up the application. We can assign the hotkeys, we can control how the mouse works. We also have the touch gestures if you have any touchscreen device. Also, the thing that amazed me was that this media player has an option to enable X input. So if you don't know about that, you can control this media player through your gamepad or any Xbox controller. You just sit down on your couch far away from your monitor and just control your media player through gamepad. So there are a lot of things that we can just talk about. So now I'm going to see the option of crystallization and noise reduction, which is inbuilt into the software. And this is very nice. It works sometimes, it sometimes doesn't work, but it is good to have this feature. So if you control the crystallization, the sound becomes a bit more sharp, as you can see. So not much difference, but still it is there. We can control the settings as we like and apply that. You can enable that and it pretty much will increase the trebles a bit, and you can have a much more sharper sound. And if you enable this feature, the noise reduction feature, it will reduce the noise or the frequency that you set here, and it will filter all that frequency away from the file as you play it. So just go and try it for yourself. If it works for you, if you can see the difference, then amazing. If you cannot, just tweak the settings and it will come. You can use this feature to like enhance your audio experience. One more thing that I would like to notify you guys is that out of the box, this software will not be able to play HEVC files or X265 files. So for that, you just need to tweak a single option, and that will allow you to play the X265 files. You just need to go to filter control, then video decoder, you go to built-in video codec settings, and from here, just change this X265 thing to FFmpeg. I think it will be defaulted to built-in or something like that, but just change it to FFmpeg and you are good to go, and it will now play all your HEVC x265 files very easily. After that, one more thing that I liked about this, I don't know if you guys will like it or not, but you can set screensaver, your video files as screensaver through this media player. So if we like set up, you can see that currently it is showing the time. You can change it, replace it with any video file that you are playing right now. Currently I'm not going to do that, but still, if you're curious, you can just go and check that out for yourself. So it will look something like this. Just a sec. It will look something like this. Very nice. But I don't like this. But it is good to have something like that. Okay, so the last thing that I want to talk about is the link sharing and streaming feature of this media player. Now, VLC is very bad at streaming or sharing the link. Honestly, I faced a lot of issues while doing so, and I don't know what is wrong with that, but whenever I open a link, VLC just crashes. But when I used this pot player while opening any link or streaming, it is very easy. You just need to do one thing. Any video on your browser, you just take this link, drag it and drop it, and it will start playing that as soon as it gets the connection. How awesome is that? You don't have to do anything, and it is very, very convenient that way. You just maximize it, change, and also from here you can change the video resolution, and it is very good to have that. This is currently the best feature that I liked about this software. Just go install it and check it out for yourselves. You will never again go back to VLC. So thank you guys for watching this video. There are a lot of things that I can further talk about this software, but I just want to keep this video short and accessible to all those people. Goodbye, and meet you guys in the next video.